We're going to continue now, talk about, well, a holiday bonus here. The owner of a group of grocery stores in the Midwest is handing over the keys to his entire business to all 400 of his employees, making all of them part owners of the business. So why is Joe Lucan turning over the reins instead of selling? Take a look.
In the holiday classic, It's a Wonderful Life, James Stewart plays George Bailey, a small-town businessman with the biggest heart in all of Bedford Falls.
Merry Christmas!
The Bedford Falls of the Midwest just could be Bemidji, Minnesota. And Bemidji's George Bailey? Well, that's gotta be Joe Lucan.
Finding everything?
Yes.
Joe owns a group of grocery stores in Minnesota and North Dakota, and he's been the boss for 46 years.
Right here.
Also, the hardest worker, making sure that every item is in place.
Put those back, would you?
And sharing many laughs along the way. And while age and Parkinson's have barely slowed him down, at 71, Joe finally decided he was ready to retire. But what to do with all his stores? Joe turned to his four sons, but none of them live in the area anymore.
He looked at me and he said, I got a great idea. He says, let's form an ESOP and let the employees own the business.
ESOP stands for Employee Stock Ownership Plan. In other words, Joe is handing over his mega million dollar business to all 400 of his employees for free.
No doubt I could have had more money, but the employees benefit. It's a win-win situation for everybody.
Joe says it was his way of giving back to his workers. Over the years, he credits them for his company's huge success.
For him to do a gift like that, they got goosebumps.
Rockin' awesome.
Quite a few wows.
Walking down the aisle, we've been blessed in every possible way. It's a gift to be able to share that now.
But early on, times were tough.
We had two babies, and we were getting tired of running out of money a week before paychecks came in.
But Joe's hard work and drive eventually paid off, and his mom and pop shop grew into a mini empire. These days, Joe still gets in his car before dawn to get to work by 4 a.m. every morning.
There's one Joe Lucan in the world. I could never replicate what he's done.
Brent Seacard started here as a 25-year-old overnight janitor. Now, he's about to get the keys to Joe's kingdom.
We just want to keep doing what Joe did.
It's up to us to make the company even stronger than what it is. And we've got big shoes to fill.
I didn't do this. My girls did this.
And while Joe takes his final bows as the boss,
I don't know what I'm going to do when I don't get to see you in the grocery aisle anymore.
One thing's for certain, the new owners will always welcome Joe back.
I think that is the perfect legacy for my dad built over the last 46 years.
It's going to go from a smaller family to a much larger family.
I want to emphasize, he is giving his business
multi-million dollar business
to his employees. Oh, that we could all work for a Joe Lucan.
Yeah.
That is for sure.